Hardly any other topic dominated the social media last week as much as the apparent Starbucks coffee cup that appeared in the new Game of Thrones episode. Many fans asked themselves how no one in the team seems to have noticed that a coffee cup is on the table at minute 17 in the middle of a series that has been so elaborately produced. Then half the world felt it was time to add their own part to it and countless memes were created. On the part of the Game of Thrones team, they did exactly the right thing. Because first, they announced with a wink that there was no coffee at all in the mentioned cup, but a herbal tea, as an answer to the huge shitstorm, then they had it removed by a CGI professional. At the end, everything is not such big of a deal, but in the future, many will still have to think of the strange coffee cup in Season 8, Episode 4. Many fans were quite surprised when they saw the new Pokémon film Master Detective Pikachu being leaked to YouTube on Tuesday. Those who were already looking forward to see the film 2 days in advance were disappointed after the first minute, which included the Warner logo and high image quality and looked surprisingly real. Afterwards, the yellow Pokémon dances 1 hour and 40 minutes to 80s music in a continuous loop across the screen. A pretty good gag, but who was actually behind it? On the one hand, this could be the Pikachu dubbing artist and Hollywood star Ryan Reynolds, who has often had a talent for unusual advertising methods in the past. This is supported by the fact that the video can still be found on YouTube. The other option is that it's just a sophisticated and quite funny fan idea. Either way, the clip stirs up the advertising drum. By the way, fans can watch the whole video in the cinema since Thursday. After Disney announced 3 film dates for the time after Star Wars Episode 9, it was now made clear that these will probably not be called Star Wars 11, 12 and 13, but take a new path. Star Wars 9, The Rise of Skywalker will definitely be the end of the saga and close the Skywalker chapter. From 2021 on, we will get to know new characters. The upcoming movies won't be in the style of the spin-offs Rogue One and especially Star Wars Solo, but will open a completely new chapter. The reason for this is certainly the lack of success with Star Wars Solo. Behind the camera of the new movies will be Game of Thrones producers David Benioff and D.B. Weiss, as well as Star Wars 8 director Rian Johnson. It is also rumored that the new films by Benioff and Weiss will be set in the Old Republic, the Star Wars Middle Ages. However, Johnson's movie is supposed to be something completely new, which nobody has on their radar. So you will see what Disney is going to do with Star Wars in the future. The release dates so far are December 2022, 2024 and 2026. John Wick director Chad Stahelski chatted a few days ago during a John Wick promo tour and announced that the Wachowski brothers are currently working on a 4th part of the Matrix trilogy. This may come as a surprise, after all, the last Matrix part was released in 2003. During an interview with Yahoo he said, "I'm super happy that the Wachowskis are not just doing a Matrix, but they're expanding what we all loved." He also adds that he himself is curious to participate in the project. However, the upcoming film is not intended to be a remake, but to tell a completely new story from the Matrix universe. Furthermore, the original actor Keanu Reeves says that if the Wachowski brothers take over the direction again, he would like to take on a role in the new film as well. Fans of the 3 previous parts can therefore look forward to a new film of the cult series in the future, which will not only be featured with familiar faces in front, but also behind the camera. Unfortunately, more detailed information about the release date is not yet available. In the 80s and 90s, the Hellraiser series was the cult series for horror fans alongside Halloween, Nightmare on Elm Street and Friday the 13th. After some quite good parts, the movies got worse and worse and disappeared after some rather bad sequels completely into insignificance. But as The Hollywood Reporter now reports, Dark Knight author David S. Goyer was hired for a new edition of the Hellraiser films. He is supposed to give the old needle villain a new face. Unfortunately, neither the team nor the plot is known at the moment. A spokesman of the producing company Spyglass said in any case that the new Hellraiser would become dark and literally go into the guts. After 6 more or less successful parts of Wrong Turn movies, it was now confirmed that there will be another film. This one shall not be called Wrong Turn 7, but will be a reboot of the 2003 original film. According to Constantine Film, the plot revolves around a group of friends who wants to go camping in the beautiful mountains of West Virginia. However, the young New Yorkers don't quite take the warning of a local seriously, namely that they shouldn't go astray, and so the 6 friends end up in the arms of a backwoods cult. Nothing new at first. After all 6 predecessors revolve more or less around this topic. In addition, Alan B. McElroy has been brought on board, who took part not only in Halloween 4, but also in the script of the first Wrong Turn part. The Domestics director Mike P. Nelson was hired to direct the movie. The reboot is not supposed to be quite like the first part, since producer James Harris said that the reboot leads Wrong Turn in an exciting direction for a new generation of fans and that Mike P. Nelson's vision will give the viewers something they have never seen before. Despite all skepticism towards the new edition, this year's Cannes Film Festival will convince you of something better, because in the aftermath it will be finally decided whether Wrong Turn is suitable for the cinema or whether you can see it like the five parts before it, exclusively at home.